Evening, boys and girls. Recent purchase, more a novelty purchase, the Southord Pen Pick. Now, that comes, you get that, obviously, it's Southord. That's a tension wrench. You also get three other ones, which are them there, and a little key ringy thingy I've got to go through there, go through it. Now that's the first thing, is you obviously, if you were going to carry it, I presume the way it's supposed to be carried, like covertly, is you'd have to choose your tension wrench, which means you're limited to one. I used to get an elastic band and wrap the other three around the outside, and then it don't really look like a pen anymore, does it? But anyway, so you would choose the one you're going to put in, and this is what you got. Unscrew the top, you got your tension wrench, and then you got your picks. Now notice what a tight fit they are. There you go. We'll come back to that later. And you've got, it's quite a good selection of picks in there. Not slimline slim, but you got rakes and bent diamonds and shit and these fiddly little fucking things anyway, but rakes. Oh, come on. Wait on. Right, that's thrown the wrong way, man. Alright, let's go there. Right, that's what you get inside. I don't know whether you can see that. That's a bigger selection than obviously you would get on a jackknife, which I would consider another novelty item just like this. But yeah, normal Southord ones, you've got the bent half diamond, bent half round, round, double half round, snakey poos, another snakey poos, saw rake, couple of books, snowman, W tingy, another bent snake ish thing, small and large diamond. Anyway, what I would say is if you, oh yeah, and what you do obviously is choose the one you want, sling it in the end of your pick, and away you go. What I would say is if you're a novice at picking and you think this looks like the dog's bollocks, it's not really, because the weight and the balance is crap if you're gonna try an SPP anything. I would say this is for people that know how to pick and are reasonably good at picking, so you're sort of sling in your back pocket suitcase or anything when you go away. Although if customs did find it, I think there'd be a few questions, but I'll just sling a couple of locks in there and say, oh well, I'll be lock picker. Yeah, this was the way I relax. But it's quite well made, aluminium body I do believe, stainless steel picks and that. But if you're serious about picking locks, apart from the basic locks and that, this I wouldn't go with this. Get yourself a proper pick set, but it does open locks if you know what you're doing. That's this is a cheapie, And obviously, if you end up opening locks with no skill, like raking, this would be ideal, because it's and it feels unwieldy in the end. I mean, look at that sticking out the lock. It's not a, it's just not like normal picks. But you can, you know, with raking, you can open the cheap stuff. I have, believe it or not, which I think was pure luck, which I ain't gonna do now, because I think it was pure luck, picked an Asa with this. But the feedback from normal, from the normal picks that I use is crap. It's as I said, the weight, the balance, the feedback when you're picking is shit, basically. But as I said, if you know what you're doing and you can pick locks with normal picks, then you'll pick locks with this pick. Might take a bit longer, but that's it. All in all, I think quite a good little tool to sling in your back pocket, if you know what you're doing. Well, that's it. Southord Pen Pick. Not too bad. Forgot to mention, the hardest part about, hello, that's my fucking headphones are just falling apart, never mind. Forgot to mention, the hardest part, you just seen me rake that lock, the hardest part is getting these fuckers back into there. Because believe me, it's, if you're only good at a Rubik cube and conundrums and, I don't know, puzzle shit, it's good, because the first ones, they go back in okay. Notice I'm alternating up and down, and you give it a shake. Now that's alright. There's obviously a way I haven't worked out yet, because that's pretty jam-packed, and I've still got two to go in. And look, there's one sticking and binding already. Believe me, it'll probably take you longer to get the picks back in than it will to pick the fucking lock. I mean, look at that. Can you see that? No, you can't. Well, that, well, you can. I'll bring it back in a little bit. It's like sort of jam-packed solid, and you're trying to get the picks in. So it takes, yeah, see, and they're stuck. So you have to fuck about for an eternity and try and get the ones in, or try and get the picks in. I don't know, we put the bent diamonds down first, let's have a go with a snake rake up. Oh, it's not, it's a saw rake. Oh, do this. Anyway, I'll probably take up millions of times trying to do this. I do go back in eventually with a shake and a wiggle and different configurations of up and down, but that's the only thing with having so many picks, I suppose. But as you can see, look, I've still got three left and I'm jamming up left, right and centre. Anyway, that's the only thing that I forgot to add when I just watch the video back. Anyway, bye. Try and get in free.